What's up, people? We're back at it once again on this here game, and I'm going to spare y'all for today. I'm not going to mention my Kick channel, my Kick streaming channel, and I'm not going to mention my second YouTube channel. If you want to know what either one of those things are, go back one video. I've been repeating myself like the past like 6 days, and I'm getting kind of tired of it, so we's going to take a break. That's what we's going to do. But we're going to go onto Bridges as soon as damn game loads. And it's going to load now. A bit delayed, but hey, we're there. Look where we spawned at, guys. Look where we spawned at. Pretty much the middle of nowhere. Pretty much. And you know, one could argue that this entire damn map is middle of nowhere. One could argue. But I'd rather spawn at, like, the river, to be honest. Because at least then, I'm in the middle of the map. And, you know, more times out of 10, the people at the top of the map get into a gunfight quicker than people do down here. Because down here is bigger than up there. Check the map. Okay, so the guy that I was looking for, the guy that spawns behind this yellow house on my right-hand side, he's not in the house. You see, I'm looking back there. He's not in the house. He ran straight for the detector. And you can tell by how I'm moving that I figured that out. He ran straight for that. Now that we know, or that we inferred, rather, that he's there, what do you think he's going to do with information? Well, he does this. Jet, how did you know exactly that it was him? I mean, hey, anybody could have had a port, you know? So how do you know it's him? Well, look at his loadout, people. He has a port. You see, guys, no one carries only one port. If you're going to go big, you're going to go big. And let me tell y'all, when ports were first introduced into this game, it low-key broke it. It low-key did. But we're gonna come back to that, because I'm gonna hit the detector myself. And not really a spoiler alert, because y'all are right about to see it right now. I'm low-key surrounded. So I'm gonna go after the nearest guy to me. Makes sense, right? Top tip, fellas, when you see, if not hear, the detector go off, don't sit in the same area, because that's how you get killed. That is how you get killed quickly. Now, like I said, we're going to come back to the whole ports ordeal, but that star I just removed, didn't we just see somebody back there? Now, you also see me looking directly at where that guy was attended at. People, I'm trying to not get third party. That's why I'm relocating over here. It's not about, you know, hearing them. In this case, it's about seeing them. You should notice that there's a dynamic going on. If it's nighttime, you want to hear them. But if it's daytime, you want to see them. Now, I'm thinking ahead here. I'm going to put my transmitter down right there. Because if the guy that was detected behind me uses the detector, then he's going to find a transmitter. And that's what I want. But back to ports, though. I want to say, I took a break from this game when the SVU came in. Then when I came back, I played for about maybe a week, if not 3 weeks. Then I made a YouTube channel. Or then I started uploading to the YouTube channel. I mean, I've been at his channel, just didn't never upload anything on it. Yeah, I can remember when I first got ported. I was like, boy, what the hell? And then a trio. That's all you really need to know. That's all you need to know. Why am I coming back here? Well, the safe is being unlocked. Yeah. And if my memory serves right, and I can, you know, look at my phone and tell, the barred house is back here. But I come to the sudden realization that homeboy is probably gone by now. And someone just relocated the airdrop. So I'm looking behind myself and I'm saying, you know what, you can survive for this time. You can. Because I want to say that people are still at the top of the map. And, you know, that's a pretty safe bet to say. Because we haven't heard a whole lot of gunfights. At least I think we haven't. At this point in the video. But hey, here's something that you all should take to heart. Quiet does not mean safe. And there you go. A full auto bugle to my what? What direction is that? Like northwest? Yeah. And it's kind of, it's not a coincidence, rather, that a comm station's near the northwest. And the damn container's going off. Now, I can tell you this, because I play shootouts a lot. I mean, I upload one every day at midnight. That was a UK VZ-59. A light machine gun that fires SVU ammunition. And we all know how bad an SVU hurts. So why is a light machine gun that fires SVU ammunition shooting off the locks on a container? You have a light machine gun. But then again, that light machine gun is not meant for headshots. But how many people you think actually shoot for the head? I mean, like, wait, line up, fire one bullet, and call it a day. Yeah, nobody. Homeboy's trying to get a second gun. That's what I'm trying to tell y'all. So look, I'm running over here, right? The comm station we just passed, I can't use. So whoever's up here, whoever relocated the airdrop, is probably still up here. Probably. People, here's something you should never trust. A closed container.
Airdrop incoming. Get ready.
Okay, cool. That guy's down. But he was awfully, what's the word? Suspicious walking around that area. He was crouch walking in broad daylight with his back turned to the sun. Yeah, that's something you never do. Like, ever. In real life and or in the game. So I'm running over here to see what this guy has on him. And luckily for me, I actually remember where he died at. And more importantly, it's daytime. he doesn't have a UK. So whoever has a UK is still around. Because remember, first we heard a full auto bugle, then we heard a UK open this damn container, or shoot off one of the locks on it. The container itself is not open. 2 + 2 = 4. Homeboy is still around, if not still alive. That UK fired what, like 1, if not 3 rounds of ammunition? The container went off, and that's all we heard from it. And the container's still closed. Yeah, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure shit out, you know? Speaking of shit, I'm near the damn porta potties in the barn. That shit crazy. Anyways, airdrop. Right? Airdrop. It's still on the ground. It's still on the ground. Now, like I said, somebody relocated the landing area of the airdrop. The fact that no one has came up to it and got it yet makes me think either I killed the guy who relocated the airdrop, or it's being watched and I don't see who's watching it. That's why I throw the grenade from behind this fence here. And I'm like, you know, looking around and crap, because all it takes is for one second to look and be like, wait a minute, why is there a circle against the leaf? That's somebody's head. Boom, headshot. But I decide to go ahead and move around. I decide to. Because look, the container itself is still closed. It still is. And luckily for me, I happen to have two very important things. And I just saw my consumable wheel flash up there. People, for once in a YouTube video where I play this head ass game, I'm going to use a jammer. And I'm going to pull it out right here. Okay. Jammer is now placed. Like so. Fantastic. What's the next move? The next move is a port. And the person is right there. Okay, cool. Now, I'm thinking it's a hostile bush, right? And I'm probably right about that statement. And we all know most hostile bushes don't move. But this one does. Mortar strikes land, nothing. No splats, no person running away. Hell, the damn airdrop is not even recovered. And I turned around with my camera to shake at the jammer saying, damn, I should have stayed right there. I should have, but how was I going to know that dude had a port? Most people in this game don't carry ports. Most. But when they do, oh, you know, trust me. Alright, so look, dude used one port, right? Right? Okay. So where is he at now? Did he leave? I mean, I don't know. But look, I get ported again. Radiation is already at the top of the map, guys. And he ported me on the way to this exit. Yeah. And so he does that. People, this is the most pure, how can I put it? The most pure example of the last second meta. Most pure example. Now, I will say this. I want to say I probably slight amount of my Mortar Strike. I probably did. And if you're saying to yourself, Jet, why the hell didn't you go over there? People, what did we hear last? A UK. What did we hear before the UK? A bugle. Do you want to fuck around and find out which bush is carrying a light machine gun or a fully automatic assault rifle? Yeah. I don't fancy those chances. I don't. And I want to say, homeboy, after doing all of that, when I say all of that, I mean nothing. He didn't even grab the container. So I was either going to approach him on his territory when we both know that we're near each other, or play it safe and try to spot him from a distance. Distance meaning from that rock, and try to gun him down with a bugle. Shit didn't work out. Yeah. So what's the moral of this video? What's the moral? Well, I'm gonna give you the most obvious thing you should learn from this here video. People don't carry one port. They carry two. And to those of you who are like, Jet, why don't you play duos and teams and trios and crap? The answer is quite simple. If one person has two ports and they hunt you down, imagine if three people have two ports and they try to hunt you down. Imagine that. Also, imagine all three people carrying powerful weapons with body armor. Trios and duos is not fun to me, people. That's why I don't play teams. Quite simple. At least when it comes to my solo play, I know for a fact, oh, it's one person. I can take him out with a headshot and keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? But duos and trios and lone wolf turn on, nah. That's a game on hard mode. Back in the day, when the Sumi was the meta weapon, you might catch me with lone wolf on. You might. But in 2023, hell, 2022 and beyond, I'll pass. But hey, I want to thank y'all for watching, and I'll see you next time. Until then, peace.